Uncle Chunt.
Uncle Chunt here for Chunt TV. Holy shit, look what we've got here. Something big and Zio-y and staffy. Oh my lord. Look at it. Let's open this bastard. It's quite tall. I think it's like 40 something inches. It's taller than I thought it would actually be. And look, this thing, it's quite large. Let's get it out of the way for a moment. This thing I got for myself because it was my You Survived the move from Rocky to Newcastle to Sydney to Brisbane and got a job. You survived all of that and got settled. Treat yourself. So I did. So I got this thing. And I'm quite happy I did. I wasn't going to because I've got other more important things to sort out, but I thought, you know, it's tough it, you know, treat myself a little bit as a reward for persevering. So let's open this bastard. Right, yeah. Whoop, what's that? Air Culture Shock and Collectibles. Yes, that's where I got it from. Plug. Culture Shock, Collectibles. Yeah. They were really cool about me ordering this. Well, not just ordering it, but they allowed me time to pay it, so they were really cool. You know, they just wanted some communication to know what was going on, and I got to talk to them before they actually got their shipment in and everything, so just to make sure what the actual go is, see if I can do it. My. This is quite special. Now, those of you that are familiar with me know that pretty much my favorite ranger is the Gold Zio Ranger, and his Zord, the Carrier Zord Pyramidus. So I had to have this. I remember years ago, within the last three or four years ago, I almost bought the Japanese toy 90s version. Like, it's like this tall or something like that. I don't know. I almost got it once because I was like, well, we're never going to get a one-to-one scale replica of this thing. I'm glad I held out because here's a one-to-one scale replica of the Zio staff. Oh my god. Alright, so there's nothing in that egg carton. Wow. Holy moly. This is pretty special. Yeah, let's get it out. Just trying to figure out if it actually comes with batteries. Right, so adult assembly required. Use a small screwdriver, not included. Naturally. Turn the screw, blah blah blah. Remove back, it's covered, da da da. Into battery compartment. Note, make sure you use new batteries. What? Insert two AAA batteries, making sure. Replace. What? So this doesn't come with batteries? Oh my fucking god, are you kidding me? The price these things are, why don't they come with batteries? Open up the back here, it says, and I have to unscrew it. So, geez, really? So maybe it doesn't come with batteries? How lame. Well, this would have been a really, really short, shitty video, but I found some batteries, so let's give it a go. Yep. Definitely no batteries in this thing. Man, seriously, that's just, I'm sorry, Bandai Namco. This isn't a slight at Culture Shock at all. This is more aimed at Namco Bandai. You're cheapening out on batteries for the cost of this freaking thing. Like, and it's like, I'm stoked to have it, but this thing, like, it's plastic, man, with a bit of die-cast metal on these two round bits. And there's lights and sounds and stuff, but seriously, for the price these things are, how dare you? How dare you not include batteries in it? Unbelievable. Alrighty, well, let's put the batteries in and put the case on. So now we can actually talk about this thing as a real item that's existing in my hands right now. I am stoked to have this. No regrets in buying this. Like, really. we'll go through some lights and sounds. I'm sure that most of you have already seen this online already, but in Australia we get things a little bit later, and partially my fault, I took a bit longer in paying for it. But this is legit, man. This is like, I'd imagine, one-to-one scale from the show. I mean, that's freaking unreal. I can't wait to get my pyraminders back when I go collect the rest of my belongings at the other house. And I just need to get another helmet. I had a helmet once, I had to sell it. If you go to the Instagram account, Power Rangers AU on Instagram, and look through his photos, you'll see a Gold Ranger helmet. That's mine. Was mine. It's in a good house now. It's in the best house that I could probably imagine it ever being in. Well, let's go through some of the sounds. So I'll open it up. And I've got to turn it on. Whooshing. Right. Now, I'm not sure exactly how much it can do, but I know if you can bring this down. Oh, that's sick. See, oh, the lights went on as well. Don't know how long or how good the lights will come across up the top here in the red with the I've got the strong lights on. So this becomes like more of his weapon mode, his blade mode. That's unreal. I love this. This, oh god. See, it's as much as it sucks being an adult sometimes. At least if you have a paying job, you can get all these rad things that are geared towards that demographic, and it's worth it. So we'll open the top. Oh my god, it's a Gold Ranger thing. And it starts playing. Basically what the lights are doing here is it's blinking relatively on the beat. I don't know about you, but that's pretty damn sweet. It doesn't beat the Green Ranger song or the White Ranger Power, whatever it is, those songs. It's in the vein of those traditional Sixth Ranger songs from the MMPR days. But it's so good to see Gold Ranger Jason moving along from the Red Ranger and Mighty Morphin, brought back as the Sixth Ranger for Zio, getting some love. I mean, it's just been so much Tommy Oliver. Like, yeah, he's the most popular, he's the face of Mighty Morphin Power Rangers, the Green and White Ranger, and Tommy Oliver. But it's good to see that Jason Lee Scott getting some love, not only as a Red Ranger, but as his Zio counterpart. I love this. I think I have no regrets. This will go on the cool tree along with... Whoa. Okay, so this did something just due to inactivity by the looks. But this goes on the same cool tree as the Gears of War lances that I have. The one-to-one scale. I mean, it's just... I want to get some more one-to-one scale replica props. Now, this isn't the first legacy item I've owned. I used to own the Green Ranger Dagger. I missed out on the White Ranger Saber Sword. I used to have all the legacy Megazords. Megazord, Dragonzord, Titanus. I had two Gold Morphers, so I could have one for White Ranger, one for Green Ranger, and then the standard Legacy Morpher with all the coins. Like, I had all the shit, but I had to sell it all. So this is kind of my... not only my kind of... you succeeded in life for a moment, but also part of me going, you know what, damn it, I'm pissed off that I sold all that stuff. I want a piece of it back. So I'm glad this is representation of that, and just so happens to be my favorite Ranger. So unfortunately, Namco Bandai only released the Gold Ranger Communicator to some Comic Con in America. Can't remember what it was, but wasn't available to us in the public. So I'll never get that. And it's on eBay for like hundreds of dollars, and I'm not paying that. Hasbro. Unless Hasbro wake up themselves and go, you know what, we've got money to make here, it's just left on the table. Of people that missed out on the Gold Ranger Communicator, Legacy Communicator. Hopefully they just re-release it. Because with this, my Pyramidus, the Communicator, and when I get another helmet, I want to complete my Gold Ranger Zeo Shrine. So, I love this. This is just so rad. Man, imagine if you had this as a kid. Like, the amount this cost, I wouldn't have bought it for my kid if I had one, but this is unreal. Like, this is kind of what I imagine getting the original toy would have felt like as a kid, but just as adult size. Unreal. Yes, I am 31. Can't remember how old I am. 31 this year or something. I don't give a fuck. This is so cool. I know this has kind of been a bit of a random unboxing video. I'm more just in awe of this thing rather than being able to talk about it. Yeah, it's a bit more plasticky than I thought it'd be. I wouldn't want it to be much more heavier than it is. Like, most of the weight is in the head here. I am a little disappointed. Like, it says on the box, die-cast parts. But there's only, like, this little ring, this coin, zero coin on the front and back, that are die-cast. And I'm so used to more parts of these die-cast legacy model items having more die-cast on them. I don't know what else could be justified for the weight and the price. Like, maybe this whole gold hilt, like, that's just plastic, or maybe those two parts at the top there, but I don't know, it might have been too heavy for shipping costs. And I understand, I mean, I can't have too many gripes, considering how much it would have cost to produce this and even risk putting it out, because Zero wasn't the most powerful, wasn't the most popular season, so it was a risk even putting this out. But I guarantee you that, I mean, there's a lot of Zio love out there, and I guarantee you that Austin St. John returning to the Comic-Con circuits and, you know, being close to fans and all that kind of stuff, I mean, that would have really helped Namco Bandai, or Bandai Namco, pushing ahead with, let's give this a go, because he's really out there with the fans and bringing the Zio love. And the other rangers are doing it as well, like Steve Cardenas, he's repping the Zio a lot these days. And Johnny on Bosch as well, he's repping the Zio a lot in his circuit, so it is out there. Yeah, look, so hopefully the B-roll I've been playing over the top of this gives you a bit more of a look on it. I must say, overall, I have my reservations based on some things I've seen online from others that have got this and from their initial reactions of it. But I'm glad I went through with it. I'm glad I have it. And I need to find a stand that I can hang it up on somewhere. And like in an office space or in the lounge room or something, I'd love to have a little shrine that I can set up for this guy. And I have to say, if this is what kind of risk they're willing to take to put something like this out there, God, imagine the rest of the main, more popular weapons that they can put out. I mean, they've already got out the Red Ranger sword, the Power Blaster, you know, the Morphers, the Communicators. You got the Zeomorphers out now, this, there's more Legacy Megazords coming, which is awesome. Look, I'm not a massive fan of every season of Power Rangers, so I don't really care for much after Zeo, up until like Dino Thunder and SPD and Megaforce, and you know, Samurai as well. I didn't mind Samurai, I thought it was pretty cool. So, look, if they go through, look, that's enough out of you. Oh, I just made more noise. Okay, now that I've shut that up for a bit, my personal wish, I'd love to see some Legacy Megaforce weapons. Now, I know nobody likes Megaforce. Well, not nobody. I know people do like it. I'm one of them. I would love to have a Legacy Morpher from Megaforce. This one here is not considerably, but it's a fair bit smaller than the Japanese counterpart, which is what they actually used on the show. I would love to see a Legacy version of this, but then some would say, why don't you just go get the Japanese one, which is a fair call. But I would love to see a big one, like all in gold like this, or some more golden paint. Like, I don't know, maybe I'm just wishing for something that'll never happen, because this one didn't quite have the popularity in the, as far as I understand, the Super Sentai that it came from wasn't overly popular in Japan either. So, I don't know. Let me know what you think about this. And what other Power Ranger seasons would you love to have one-to-one scale replica weapons and morphers and whatever have you. The paraphernalia that comes from each season. Which one would you like to have something like this recreated? Because, look, as a Golden Zio Power Ranger fan, I'm so stoked. And, look, I don't know what else to say. I've been quite speechless throughout this whole video. I know it's not the most exciting unboxing of this thing, but it's kind of caught me off guard a little bit. It's just so cool that these things exist for us, that we can get such things. I know they're definitely aiming towards the adult collector, definitely. And you would never buy something like this for your kid, but man, unreal. Anyway, my name's Uncle Chunt. Just want to say thanks to my supporters as well, and my Patreon supporters. It's most appreciative. Every time I edit a video and I remember to put the Patreon logo in there and check my page, I'm always like, wow, you know, I'm just amazed that someone actually wants to support me monetarily. It's amazing. And you know, I know that not everybody supports me for the same reasons, but I am a channel that wants to do more than just gaming related stuff, so hopefully you find interest in the other videos I put up as well. I know I'm not my usual energetic and speaking a million miles an hour and all that kind of stuff, but yeah, this is just too cool. I'm just flabbergasted. So I'll catch you in the next video. If you like my shit, throw us a bit. And toodaloos, enjoy yourselves.
Uncle Chunt.
Thanks for watching this video. I really appreciate it. If you haven't already, please subscribe and check out some of my other recent videos. Have a good one.